friends, it's Brian here, and I went ahead and bought a Harbor Freight 10x10 canopy because, yeah, it's 91 degrees, and in the sun it feels like it's 191, and yeah, this is makes a nice difference. So I've got a little bit of cleanup down here. I'm going to try and get some of this debris out. I need to vacuum the bottom of the door. There's a bunch of debris in the bottom of the door, so that's what I'm going to work on next. And then I'm going to start seeing how much of this glow plug system I can take out of here. We're going to find out just how big a problem we got with the glow plugs. And then I'm going to work. So we're going to start relocating the glow plug system, but first, we're going to vacuum trash out of the valley. It's all clean except for a leaf in this back corner. So if you're gonna work on this kind of truck, I really think you need something like this, maybe even what's called an overhead creeper, but for now I'm gonna use this, and that lets me get up here and actually see what's going on. Yeah, an overhead creeper would be nice. We'll see how much of this crap I can get to. Not much. Let's come out of here. Let's just throw some coke in there. God damn it, there's just no way around this. I really need to get into these crevices. Let me go see what else I can find. All right, I've got a little tiny vacuum here. Thank you. point this truck sat with the hood off because those are all leaves and rat and mouse droppings. Alright, I think we're to the point where we can try and take one of these off, so let me regroup and I'll do that. Alright, let's see. Let me get comfortable here. Pop that loose. Alright, that was easy. Now, moment of truth, did they use Motorcraft plugs? They did. So they come right out. Hallelujah. We're still replacing them. Auto light. Yeah. That's not a good sign. Alright, so if you hang out around these engines enough, you'll have people tell you you should only use the plugs that they were designed for, which is the Autolite, I'm sorry, the Motorcraft plugs. So I'm going to put a touch of anti-seize on here because that is the right thing to do. And I'm going to start it by hand because I have no desire to put helicoil in anything that's in there. And then I need to go look up the torque spec and get a torque wrench, so I'll be right back. After I get this hand tight. Alright, so let me get in here and get comfortable again. So it's 14 foot-pounds is the correct torque. And most torque wrenches are calibrated to small ones like this. So can't get to that one, so we're going to move to the next one. There is my little wrench. Now, Autolite is a Ford brand. Apparently, it's not good enough. Because I don't feel comfortable with it. there's a nice way to get back here. I don't know. That's fried, huh? Maybe. More vacuuming, there's a bunch of rat shit and stuff back here. Get a blanket to lay over this. I'll be right back. All right, so I've just got a nice furniture blanket because the stuff at the top front of the engine is it's not sharp. It's just not comfortable. Are just burned. To put in. And always want to start these by hand. Now that it's started, we'll finish it with a ratchet. Wrench. extension swivel. Let me go find that. Actually, before I do, disturb this crap that's around this glow plug. Alright, and let me vacuum it out. Alright, unfortunately the best I can do is a flex extension, and these don't hold torque real well, but I think it'll be okay because these are such low torque. So, barring that, probably gonna have to take these loose. And I think this is probably just as well, because I don't like this style of extension. Find that. Alright, this is a 7/16. And of course there's one on both sides. So let me go get a 7/16 wrench. Alright, so not trying to take these off. I just want to see if I can create a little flex. Okay, so I have enough flex to get in here. It might be. Let's see if you guys can see what I'm doing. That's gonna have to come off. No two ways around it. Dangerous place to set stuff, but is where'd that go? Alright, let me go get a magnet for that. Oh, there it is. So it's straight down. Alright. Now let's take these two and set them someplace different. Where they're at up there. might need a screwdriver. It really needs one of these lines removed. And that would be that one. But Jesus, what a pain in the butt. Alright. Piece of shit. Oh no, this is actually a Remu, or a Beru. So that's actually the right plug. Beru makes them for Motorcraft. Still getting replaced. So I've applied a little bit of anti-seize to the threads. I don't like seeing shit get put in there, but it is what it is. I saw that dirt go in there, damn it. It'll blow through, do a little bit of damage here and there. It's a nice loose engine, so it'll eat it. Just is what it is. No telling how long they ran it with no air filter. Clamps. I mean, that's shot, but that's not today's project. So we're gonna just put this back in. Clockwise fashion. And the first step is to dislodge all this junk that's down here. And might as well do this one too. Froggy, so I'm gonna do both of these. So what I noticed is that when I loosened them, some dust got created. So I'm gonna get rid of that. I don't want it dropping down in the cylinder like the last one on the other side. All
admit this one. Another auto light piece of shit. So basically they changed what they could get to. That doesn't even surprise me. So normally I would tell you, I'll put a link to the part that I'm using for the Motorcraft, but actually I want you to buy these through a reputable source, so don't use Amazon. This is something that is prone to being counterfeited, so I want you to purchase these through an AutoZone or an O'Reilly or a Ford dealer or a RockAuto, where you know that they're coming from an official source. Unfortunately, Amazon's quality control is non-existent. By Amazon, might as well be China. They don't give a shit if there's counterfeit product there or not. And this is something that gets counterfeited, and it's real hard to tell apart. And it can destroy your engine if it's not a quality part. So you really want Motorcraft. And RockAuto sells these for like $9 a piece. Mine came in a plastic bag. I was kind of surprised. I honestly expected to get them in a box. But I think that's okay. All right, that's that one. Here's this one. Oh, there's no name mark. There's no markings that I can discern on this. Who knows what it is? Mistake, but it's probably pretty close. Yep, not over tightened. All right, that's 6 of 8. And I'm gonna take a little bit of a break here for a second, and I'll be right back. All right, hopefully y'all can see that. So we're gonna get in here and go after the number one connection. Jesus Christ. list of shit that I need to buy. Alright, so let's clean this up and disturb all this crap. Process before. The crap against the edge of the threads where they meet the block or the cylinder head breaks loose when you loosen the bolt. Let me go get some pliers. All right, so it's not stuck. I just can't reach it with my fingers. And these aren't the pliers I would have chosen. There we go, I guess I can reach it with my fingers. Alright, let me get the replacement. So it doesn't take a whole lot of this anti-seize material. That's plenty. Alright, so we'll just push that down in there and then we'll reach in here with the socket. No idea what thread pitch this is, but it's been real well behaved. The other ones. triggered something bad. Yeah, I kicked my sockets onto the ground. I'll deal with that in a minute. Glow plugs have been replaced. So the next phase of this project is to relook. That's the glow plug controller. And I'm going to relocate it from back here on the back of the engine. And I'm going to move it to the sidewall. And so I've got to undo all this wiring. All this wiring shot to hell anyway. So we gotta get this harness out of here. And build a new harness. That should be a lot of fun. And then we'll see if the glow plug system works the way it's supposed to. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. And remember, use ZD29 Motorcraft glow plugs.